There's been a lot of discussion recently in relation to English film music about bowing patterns. Many people think there's no particular bowing patterns were used in English fiddle music, but if you do listen to some of the traditional fiddle players that were recorded, particularly, for example, Stephen Baldwin from Herefordshire, you can hear quite clearly that he uses consistent patterns in his bowing. And these bowing patterns are explained beautifully in a book that was published about 100 years ago by a gentleman called William Honeyman. He's a tutor for Scottish fiddle music, and it explains how to play strathspeys and reels. But right at the very end, there's a chapter devoted to playing hornpipes, and he describes three different styles of playing hornpipes using different bowing patterns. These are the sailor's hornpipe style, the Newcastle style, and the Sandance style. So the first style, the sailor's hornpipe style, is characterised by each group of four quavers in a hornpipe. The first two notes are joined together in one bow stroke, and then the notes three and four are separate ones. So, for example, in the first bit of the tune, it goes like this. The West End hornpipe, using the sailor's hornpipe style of bowing. The second bowing style is the Newcastle style, and here is characterised by, first of all, the tune actually having a dotted rhythm. So the first quaver in each group of four is dotted, and then the second note is actually a semi-quaver. And also the bowing pattern is that the notes two and three are joined together, and then four and one are joined together, and that pattern is repeated all the way through. So the bowing actually cuts across the actual rhythm of the tune, like this. The West End hornpipe, using the Newcastle style of bowing. And the third style is the Sandance style, and here again it's a dotted rhythm, and each note is a separate bow stroke, and it always starts with an up bow, like this. The West End hornpipe, using the Sandance style of bowing. Thank you. So those are the three bowing patterns that can be used to play hornpipes. You don't necessarily have to use any of those patterns consistently all the way through a tune. You can actually vary it and add in, you know, extemporized patterns as well. But if you listen to a lot of traditional fiddle players, they do tend to use one particular style predominantly through a piece of music. Hope you find that interesting.